Hey, what's up, you bitches and sluts and whores? It's Dandy.
And Hansy.
Back with another video. And guys, we're at episode 9 of RuPaul's Drag Race season 12.
Episode 9. No, I did this.
No, I was going like that. Girls and gals and girls and gays, we have a night, bitch.
Shit.
I don't know who the fuck decided in VH1 and RuPaul's Drag Race that it was an exquisite idea to premiere Celebrity Drag Race along with this season.
RuPaul Charles.
Like, come
it's
on.
Who the fuck?
We could have done it on a different day.
Girl.
Girl, I want something to be excited about on Thursdays and Saturdays and shit.
All on Friday, y'all.
But it is what it is. It's a party. So welcome to the first half of our party, bitch.
We're going to be doing Celebrity Drag Race. And so, yes, we're so excited.
So excited
it's going
to
be a fun-filled drag night, you guys.
So, as always, we're going to read our favorite comments from last week. My favorite comment was from Gregory Ray Dorf. Wait. Hold up. I said hold up. That's H to the O to the L to the D to the hold up. Ain't that a little terrarium in the left top corner of your video? Bitch, when I read that, I fell to the floor, bitch. Like, I'm gutted. Like, I am done. This bitch right here, y'all don't miss nothing. Let me close this door so you don't see what else is back there, bitch. This is a fucking terrarium?
No.
This is a tarantula? This is, what is it?
No.
It looks like it.
This looks like it. This is what looks what they were holding up, but this is a candle, honey.
No, bitch. I think it's a tarantula.
A terrarium.
It's a tarantula. Girl, I was gagged. And then the comment below it, comment with it, Distant Dreams, left a comment that said, remember the other guy said he's dumb.
I didn't mean that. I'm sorry.
I'm shooken. I am done.
But he is.
When I read that, I like, fell to the floor, bitch.
Terrarium, bitch. Those are not terrariums. Those are little candle holders, you guys, with a fake ass candle because we're fake as fuck.
Fake, bitch.
Oh, how cute.
Okay. In honor of the tarantulium.
Yes. My comment comes from Robin Brown.
Oh.
And her picture is Beyonce.
It's Beyonce.
With the wind in the hair. Yeah.
Bitch, that's Beyonce.
Honestly, if you're going to review both Drag Race and Celeb Drag Race, just get them both out as soon as you can. Believe I live for your reactions.
Thank you.
That's what we're going to try to do, you guys.
I'm going
to
edit this one. He's going to edit the other one. Whenever they get out, they get out.
We're
going
to try to get them all out. So
tonight,
if you're here watching regular Drag Race, go check out our other video.
Yes, please.
Please. And give it a like. And if you've watched both, go ahead and just subscribe.
Oh, bitch, I love that for us.
Right?
Yes.
I mean, you watched one, go ahead and subscribe so you can watch next week's.
Cheers to that, bitch.
Or
remember,
catch up on all the rest.
I'm trying to get to 30K. 30K, bitch, get me there.
Yeah,
so.
He aims pretty low, you guys. So if we can get to 100,000, that'd be great. But 30K,
I
love yeah.
So let's get a fucking cocktail started. Okay. Today's the night, this bottle,
yes,
I'm expecting to get it down to the bottom, girl.
Oh, she's gonna dip it low. Pick it up slow.
Listen, y'all, we decided not to go to Sam's Club this week. We went to Aldi's.
Yes,
and girl, we spent $70 and bought groceries for the year.
No, $70, and most of it was wine.
Okay.
We came back with like 5 bottles of wine.
Yeah,
guys. 5 bottles of wine and groceries for at least like a week. But they're also like $2 a bottle. But we did find this really cute peach wine.
It's good.
And girl,
it's good.
Look, oh, girl, oh, yes, ASMR, I love that for us. I just got this $3 Merlot for the ho-ho. Oh, this is probably not a good idea to get on our new jeans. Look at the jeans we made on TikTok, y'all. Okay, little fashion show moment. We made these in honor of
quarantine.
Gigi Goode. No, Gigi Goode.
Oh, in honor of Gigi Goode.
And TikTok, if you want to follow
so
me
cute.
On TikTok. The link will be down below.
I put little safety pins on mine.
I know, yours came out exquisite. Like, these would be at least $50 in the store. And we thrifted both of these.
And we thrifted, yeah.
Okay, so
not
cheers.
Recently.
No, not recently. In honor of Crystal Method for thrifting, cheers to a night of fun, bitch.
Ow!
Let's roll it. Ooh, you like that.
Oh, good.
Your lips look really... Did you get a lip job?
Yeah.
Okay, great. I had a little lip injection before we came here. Awesome.
Oh, I forgot these black looks.
Well, there you have it. Jan has been eliminated from the competition.
Aww. Hi, Jan.
Before, I was like, if I have lipstick for my life, that bitch may be ready to go back to where she came from.
Ooh. And that's what she did, y'all.
Grateful.
To her home.
And remember, you're on RuPaul's Drag Race.
Oh, you let us, you made us all remember.
I know a dream come true for her. Every day was a bliss to her. She was always so happy and chipper. My girl, why are you so happy? So, oh,
Jan really was very upbeat, and so it's gonna be kind of.
All Drag Race.
Oh my gosh.
And a Barbie and a cheerleader all had like an orgy, and then like they made a robot cheerleader baby.
Preach.
I want to congratulate your country ass.
Oh my god, I forgot about this bitch. Adio. Us after that stimulus check, y'all. Freeze.
Good. I feel like I went from a 10 to a 1 really quick, and I think it was because I definitely went into this challenge, you know, being like, I won the last challenge, I'm gonna win this one, I'm so excited.
I didn't see her as being that cocky.
Gigi? Oh. Cocky?
Oh!
I will never guess.
Okay, the gaggery.
Sometimes you have to learn lessons like trust your instincts and know that whatever you decide to do, you just need to follow your mind. My daddy used to always tell us that keep your ass right and your mind will keep your mind right and your ass will follow. So
I like the first one.
Keep your ass right.
I like that one, Jaida.
Or clean your ass right.
I was crushed for me to realize how important it is.
I was like, if I don't step this game up now, honey, there's not gonna be a game to step up anymore.
Come on, Heidi Ho. Sex with Jaida the cat.
She's a like sexy kitten.
Oh.
would.
Gigi. What are you don't be doing this to us, Gigi.
What's this?
That's a ball of yarn.
An unfinished garment. I seem to be stuck.
Gigi is giving me life.
That hat, that outfit's pretty cool.
Holy fuck.
Wow.
But
one
of you was perfect. Ooh,
Crystal, Jackie, or who do you think?
Crystal or Jackie?
Jackie. Jackie can only win these mini challenges. She's gonna have a lot of gift cards, sister.
Okay, now ladies, we are done pussyfooting around. The upcoming election is some serious business.
Okay,
and we
like
at Rupauls Drag Race urge everyone to vote.
Please
so
go vote.
We can keep
please,
democracy
please
alive
vote.
And well. However, to lift the spirits of our candidates and their hardworking supporters, we like to provide some comic relief. It's time for America's first drag queen president.
Could you imagine?
For this week's Max,
that would never happen, but
please let this happen.
Choices 2020.
This
presidential debate in history. Each of you will present your platform and answer probing questions from the free press.
Okay. So it's gonna be like a. Is it like a debate or something?
Wow, this is gonna be so good. It's pretty cool. But it's very, probably, I guess, improvisational.
Yes. So that's gonna be hard.
Oh. Hey, bitch. Hey.
She needs her makeup artist, bitch. She just happened to be in the back, and she's like, come on out here, girl. Look at that talk.
In your campaign.
Rue is loving this, probably.
That's smart of her to use that, kind of like Crystal.
With your win last week, I could see that you got in there and you started having fun. You started taking your time in places, and the whole thing was stupid. And that's a gift. That is a gift.
It's the gift, honey. Power of the gift. Yes.
Oh, but there's your slogan right there.
Oh, not a gift!
She got a gift. Just the most obvious thing in the world.
Handing the win over to Heidi all over again.
Giving to the GAP.
Okay.
That's so good!
Oh,
oh boy. Heidi, ho. Bitch, if she don't win this challenge again, I mean, she's not giving it to you, girl.
Oh my god, that was so good.
Hi, Gigi Goode.
Ooh, this wig is giving me Katy Perry.
I am gonna be honest, politics and the economy have always been some things that are rather terrifying to me. It's just
terrifying. Why?
I'm such an anxious person that sometimes it's really hard to watch these debates and let things come in one ear and stick in my brain and not let it go out the other.
You don't want it to come in one ear. You want it to come on your
come
tits.
On your
tits. It's not something to be afraid of. It's actually quite simple.
No,
you
not.
Have a platform.
How high?
Yeah, exactly. There's my answer.
This
I know you think
all
about it. If I were you, I would stick with what you know.
Okay, that changes everything.
You didn't think of that?
She's...
I don't know. You
hydrate.
She's literally telling these bitches how to do this competition.
Okay.
It's true, though.
Raven
go with what
you're,
like...
political...
No,
that is why I'm here today.
It's so patriotic.
So, is there anything you'd like to ask Raven?
You know, I was in the bottom last week, and I'm trying to claw my way out of that this week. So, I just want to know, how do you bring yourself out of a rut?
Don't take it seriously.
Right.
Make it stupid.
There you have it.
She loves it just to be stupid.
Yeah.
That's the second stupid comment.
Rue was probably like, when you get out there, tell them all, be stupid. Like, that's how you win.
Yeah.
Freaker.
Michelle Massage is away on assignment.
Green crew, I'm hot on the campaign trail where I'll be watching the debate.
That Oh my god!
Fucking broccoli!
Keep trying to make the broccoli happen. The broccoli's not gonna happen!
What's the runway
look?
Better vote. I love that.
Hi there. My name is Jeff Goldblum.
And I'm Rachel Bloom.
We want to welcome you to Choices 2020. Choices.
Tonight, our leading seven candidates have gathered to untuck the issue.
Let's get this wig party started with opening statements.
All right.
From the Big Apple. So good.
My mother tucking Americans, I am here to take America off its diet.
Deserve to be drag president, and I think the answer is very clear. I've proven time and time again that I mean business in the front and audience.
Genius. That was genius.
This was so good.
Being the Southern Belle of season 12, I'm someone you can trust.
She's
with
cute,
your
but her outfit looks like it needs a dry clean
again.
Sister.
I'm fooling around with you.
Serving Kansas City royalty.
Oh, wow.
What do
oh,
I do?
Face.
You cannot have change if you just put your right foot in and take your right foot out. You have to put your left foot in and shake it all about.
Oh.
Widow Von Du, shablamming for America.
In college, I was a member of the Hokey Pokey Party.
I had no idea. What is the Hokey Pokey Party, by the way?
Conservative. It's dark time.
From Canada, by
oh,
way of
wow.
New York City, Jackie Cox.
As the first
stunning.
Canadian to run for drag president, let me assure you, I'm as American as apple poutine. I mean, pie.
Oh! That's a Canadian, y'all.
In 2020.
She's lying.
Don't be tacky.
What is that?
Vote Jackie.
Oh.
Because we can all use a little more Cox in our life.
Oh.
Next up from the
poutine
Golden
is like
spicy
gravy, right?
I'm Gigi Goode, fashion icon, pantsuit advocate, human girl. I'm here too.
Now that wig is a choice.
Politicize and accessorize
stunning.
My way to a better tomorrow.
May I commend you in your bravery in stating openly that you are a human girl.
Human girl. Not a robot.
I don't
no further questions.
And from the great Badger State of Wisconsin, Jaida Essence.
Looks like she's going to a fucking party.
You can take the bitch out of the hustle, but you cannot take the hustle out of the bitch.
Amen.
That's
girl,
why
I'm
Jaida Essence Hall of the bitches for the bitches.
Finally, a spokesperson for the bitches.
Yes, we needed it.
And all right,
Crystal Method, if you were elected first drag president, what would your first official action be?
To include bare chests and bare backs to the Second Amendment, because bare arms are not enough.
Powerful Widow Von Du.
The first thing I would do in office is do a split on the D.
Oh!
A split on the D.
Deficits. I would split the deficits in half, but if she did it, it would certainly break.
Oh!
Candidates, let's keep it civil, okay?
Jackie Cox,
done.
Same question.
I'll be recruiting Deborah Cox to disco-fy the national anthem. Can I do a little bit for you right now? Right.
Please.
Let's see.
Who's Deborah Cox?
Oh, Canada, say, can you see is what I meant? I'm so American.
You're bringing up Canada a lot.
If I were you, I would not keep pushing this Canada aspect. Gigi Goode, same question.
My first act would be to forcibly play RuPaul's cover girl in every crosswalk in the nation. It will train the men and the women of this brave country to sissy their walks on the way to work.
How would we sissy our walks?
Do you mind if I come up front?
Permission granted for you to come anywhere you like.
They're good.
Sissy that wall, girl.
Now sissy that wall.
That. Ow.
Anybody can sissy their walk in any
way they please.
Yes.
I would like to retittle that rebuttal.
Ooh.
I think the only thing that Miss Good needs to sissy is that hairline.
Okay.
Ooh.
Ladies, let's keep it simple.
Not the hairline.
I would like to retattle the retittle of her rebuttal by saying that although her hairline is awful, so is her contour line.
Wow, this scent is cold, but I'm also chilly from all the shade.
Oh,
she's good. Who is, I like this bitch.
Flawless again. Just look at me.
Good. Anybody else? I vow to make America yes, yes, Eldebarge.
Not one of my fellow candidates has a single speck of glitter on their bodies.
Mm.
I want to make America glitter again.
Yes, girl.
Little do you know that I am fully vajazzled downstairs.
Did she say vajazzled?
Yeah.
Yes, vajazzled.
Imagine what that means.
Oh, you don't
imagine.
Know
what
I vow to make America one again.
I vow to make America confused again. Because these wars have lost me. I am confused right now. I don't know what's happening. I don't know who she is. I have no idea who she is.
Are you smelling toast? So you have a little bit of a stroke?
I love toast. Don't you love waking up in the morning not knowing where you are, who you are, why you are?
I like what you're saying. Before you go anywhere, you have to ride the horse in the direction that it's going.
Mm.
I don't
yes,
own
girl.
A horse, but I love riding.
Question for everyone. Can we see your tax returns?
I would like to pass the question. Now, are we talking Canadian or American dollars?
How do you plan to engage younger voters?
That's a question.
Yeah. Yeah, what's the answer?
Look over there!
That's a good one, Jaida. I've never seen that device on the debate stage before.
She's
good.
She's
Why
doing
do you
good.
Think of drag robots taking jobs away from drag queens?
Uh-oh.
She would like it. Yeah.
Jaida, same question.
Heidi, question. Look over there!
So funny!
Controversial question.
Look over there.
Hey. I fall for it every time.
Confusion.
I think I speak for Jeff when I say that he and I are both confused bitches.
You truly are a bitch.
There was a little Kate Hepburn coming through in that.
She sure did look a good.
Here we go again.
Look.
For every challenge, we're gonna get the old lady.
Yeah.
Like,
hey, girl.
Ducking fish.
Crystal, which of these candidates do you think is the least qualified to be America's next drag president?
I know that as drag president, you'll be faced with many difficult decisions. Candidate Heidi here can't even decide on a last name.
Great
true.
The gap in your front teeth, eh? There we go.
Sis whore. Crystal.
The facts are she has no idea who Eldebarge is.
Oh, which of the candidates do you think is the least qualified?
I would have to say Miss Jackie Cox. How can you trust a drag queen when her 5 o'clock shadow is visible 24 hours out of the day? I can agree with Heidi about Jackie. If she cannot win the war against her beer, how can she win the wars that we might have to fight for America?
Wow, this was a good...
Thank you.
I like this.
The widow.
Well, is the angry politician and, that was pretty much what it was. Is an angry
she's
politician.
Like really trying to like...
yeah,
she's
really
debating.
Yeah.
Did
she
listen? She's a VP with this language.
Candidates, it's time for your closing statements.
Uh-oh.
We need to go to a buffet of love, of humor, of cherry pie.
Eldebarge.
If I can do this to my face, imagine the facelift I can give to America. I'm going
to
give away healthy glitter. I understand what the bitches of the street need, and it's not these whores. I have your back.
Thank you.
And front.
Thank you, Jaida.
If Jaida doesn't fucking win this,
seriously.
Like,
on both day, both Heidi.
On both day.
That's so wonderful and so amazing.
Jackie Cox, I have a challenge for you. Don't
I
mention Canada in your closing
Jackie
statement.
I'm here to tell you the truth, because I'm clearly very American.
Sherry and Heidi. Heidi are at the bottom.
As drag president, I'm going to prioritize,
I forgot about Gigi,
politicize,
Gigi was in the middle,
and accessorize.
You repeated that bit about the accessorizing, that's okay.
I promise you that a change is on the horizon. I say shablam for a better future.
What does shablam mean, actually?
See, uneducated. This is the problem in America. Uneducated people.
Did you just call Jeff uneducated?
You just called Jeff uneducated.
He's a dinosaur doctor.
He passed out. Night bitches. Hey. Oh,
bro, we missed you.
And finally, what's the category?
Category is Stars and Stripes Forever.
First up, you? Okay.
Method. Oh, yes, honey. She is pimping the secretarial pool.
I'm wearing a bunch of mismatched textures.
It's giving me Canada, though, but. I initially liked it, but now I just kind of think it's all over the place up here. She could have dimmed it down. That's cute. I think that wig is so pretty on her. Okay, sis. Give me that Britney red outfit. It's cute.
Rosa Parks saying that I am not getting out of my seat to Black Lives
Matter.
I am showing all that. My blackness right now for you.
Is that a particular constellation?
Looks like a big dipper from here.
And all the Sherry glitter. Kesha, I'm about to say that. I'm about to say Loki looking like Kesha.
I am American, and I am letting everybody know.
Those boots. That outfit makes me car sound for cute. Not Betsy Ross.
Jackie Cox. Come on, hijab.
Alright.
I'm wearing a beautiful flowing striped caftan, and on the top, I'm wearing a midnight blue hijab that is outlined in 50 silver stars.
Ooh,
you can be Middle Eastern, you can be Muslim, and you can still be American.
I got teary eyes, y'all. That's gorgeous. And then this bitch is coming out as Washington fucking Abraham Lincoln. I was gonna say Washington. She said Quaker Oats fantasy.
She looks amazing.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Talk about a John Hancock.
She's crossing the Delaware.
So good.
Essence Hall.
Oh, this is cool. Yes.
Alright!
I see a nipple. I saw a nipple, y'all. That's Captain America, y'all.
Not the red, white,
and blue. I'm gonna tell my waxer I want that next time. The American bikini wax.
Cute. This was Jada's night, though. I think this is Jada's night.
Jada better win this.
Oh, who thinks in the bottom?
Welcome back, ladies.
If I had to guess, it would be Widow and Sherry.
Widow and Jackie, but Jackie with that outfit.
Cherry pie.
Oh, just kidding.
Jada better win.
Oh my god, tonight was 100% Jada's night.
Please.
You're safe.
I didn't know about Heidi. She didn't really do it for me in the challenge.
Your campaign was all about confusion, but tonight, it's very clear. You are the winner of this week's
Yes. Well, fucking deserve, bitch.
Congratulations, you've won a cash tip of 5,000 dollars.
Yes, Jada.
You may join the other girls.
That judge is looking at her like he was about to pout.
Like he's gonna do something.
Mr. Methyd.
Safe, bitch.
Thank you. Oh my god, it's gonna be Widow and Jackie.
Widow's on due.
Widow's just like
on the runway.
It's probably time for her to go. 100%. Sadly.
Gigi Goode.
You're safe.
You're safe.
Come on, Jackie.
You will not see me in the bottom again.
Jackie Cox.
I know Jackie did not want to be on the bottom in this outfit.
I know.
Elimination. She two queens.
Such a moment.
Ladies. This is your last chance.
I mean,
Widows, it's time for her to finish.
I think so.
And she's like, grumpy.
They've given her so many chances. She's been in the bottom so much. It's like,
time's come. Major lip sync for your life. I am not losing this. This is my chance to redeem myself.
I'm scared, y'all.
I know, because Widow killed it last week.
What are they going to see? The Star Spangled Banner?
It up.
Bitch.
Firework.
Oh.
Where'd she get that? I mean, Jackie's giving us a show.
Jackie is hilarious.
Yes.
Oh, she took a star off, sis. Oh.
Oh, so they were only taped on.
Widow can lip sync, bitch.
Feeling the weight of everyone who's ever been told they need to go back home where they come
yes,
from.
Girl.
And I'm here to let them know that, baby, you're a firework when you have a place.
God. Yes, honey. Yes, mama. I think Jackie's got it.
100%.
Is she gonna give a show? Oh, that was so good.
He's crying.
Oh, sweet, I'm crying.
Ladies, I made my decision.
He's crying.
That was so sweet.
Jackie Cox, Shantae, you stay.
Thank you.
Oh my god, he's invested.
Won't let you down again.
You may join the other girls.
Oh. Oh my god. He's crying like he's Jan.
Remember, you're a big star. Now and forever. Now, sashay away.
I feel like I let you down.
You did not let me down.
Thank you for this amazing opportunity.
Oh
my gosh, what an episode.
What an episode.
I fucking love Jackie's look, y'all. I can't get over it.
That look was amazing.
The lip sync was good.
Jaida deserved that fucking win. Jaida. And I'm so happy.
So this brought it up. I feel like Jada's in the running to be in the finale. Yep. I feel like Crystal's in the running to be in the finale. Yep. Obviously, Gigi's in the running to be the finale. And then it's kind of up in the air, I feel like.
Yeah, oh, I don't know. But I think it's Sherry. I do think my top two is Crystal and Jaida.
Crystal and Jaida.
That's why I want either one of them to win.
I'll be happy with Crystal, Jaida, or Gigi. Honestly, that'd be... Oh.
I know, that would be awesome.
Love that. Guys, normally we'd be getting ready to watch Untucked, but since RuPaul wants to fuck up our schedule, we're going to be watching Celebrity! I'm so excited! So make sure you guys...
Check that video out.
But in this video, we're going to be watching Untucked right now.
Yeah.
So let's start Untucked!
You, honestly, today,
look stunning.
Thank you.
Wow.
You've been such, like, an incredible improvement since day one.
And that's coming from her.
The one that called me out, that was
Don't touch me. With that makeup.
Girl. She looked better. She did not say you were pretty.
So maybe I'll take tips from her. I'm taking tips. Jaida.
Okay. Good for her. Improving. That's good.
Jaida, this look is
you look amazing.
So good.
I'm blown away that you actually made this.
Well, thank God
she made that.
That's talent, y'all.
I love this.
You would know that I made it. The way it goes, and it's like,
it's made to walk on the runway, and that is.
Jackie, I just want to know where you're at, how you're feeling.
I mean, look.
That was heavy.
I was scared to wear this. There are so many people who will think what I'm doing is wrong, but there are so many people who don't even have that voice. There is such a small queer Muslim community. Even I've talked to you girls about how hard it is for me and being honest about who I am with my own family. And if you're lucky enough where this issue won't affect you, you may not know how important this is to me and so many other people.
What you did tonight on the runway was you really showed stars and stripes out there.
Yes,
and what you did for young LGBTQAI Muslim people, you literally blew the doors wide open.
Oh, for sure.
Humongous bones.
Like, people are going to talk about this.
I mean, look, I don't want this to be a sad moment for me, because more than anything, I'm proud.
Yeah.
And if I have to lip sync, I'm proud to look like this and to be myself.
Fierce, brave.
Brave.
Yeah.
Good for her.
So I want to talk. That was the first time this season that Rue raised her tone, and I was shook. Widow.
Here's looking at you, like, Widow.
How did it feel, like, because she was, like, talking directly to you when it happened.
I stayed up till 4:30 in the morning just writing stuff.
I feel like she gave that same excuse.
It just feels like it was all kind
of... I wrote all these 8 pages. Right now,
and you don't have to do that. This is all just constructive criticism.
It's really hard for me to do.
It's hard. But don't do that to yourself. The payoff is not worth it. I felt I did exactly what I thought was great. And once again,
this, you know what, Widow, you are really good at, like, what Rue was saying is, like, really important. Like, sometimes, no matter how good we think we did, it's okay to you don't have to beat yourself up about it. You know what I mean?
And
like,
she beats herself up. Everything.
If you make it past today, then tomorrow won't be better. You know what I mean?
It's no longer just one thing. It's, like, every
I feel like she's not able to pick herself up. I literally got no sleep
for this entire challenge.
I ain't no sleep because of y'all.
Hell, I should just went to sleep.
I mean, maybe.
I should have just came in, you know, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed like everybody else and just said,
out said fuck you is what you say.
Should have just came in, you know, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed like everybody else and just said, I'm tired of writing material, I'm tired of trying to put it together just to be told that it's awful. Like, and that's all I hear.
Well, it's not that it was awful, I just...
They didn't say it was
others
good.
Were better.
I'm not gonna lie, I'm crushed, devastated.
Someone's gotta be in the bottom, sis.
Yeah.
I thought I was giving so much more in this competition, but barely not.
I was gonna say better luck next time, but there is no next time.
I'm not, and there are other queens that do it better than me. It's a complete mind.
I could see that.
Do you hear what I heard?
Howdy.
I think it's me and you tonight. Can I tell you something?
Yes, if you don't mind me looking down, trying to figure out
put that on.
How my stars,
you, baby.
Trying to figure out how my stars and stripes goes back together.
Thank you. I was saying earlier back there, they were like, what's going on? Are we really best friends or is there stuff between us? And I want to tell you, my only wish is that we could have been a little closer to this competition. I see your heart and I see your pain too. And I know sometimes that's why you pull away from us sometimes. And I'm sorry if I've ever made you feel like you can't talk to me, but I really, really respect you. I think you're really incredible.
This episode, I feel like I've seen Jackie in a whole different light. I'm glad we're starting to see this side. Starting to see Jackie.
You're gonna teach me how to do those drops and kicks and stuff, aren't you? Not during this, but another.
Oh, she said, don't be doing that on stage now.
Don't do that on stage.
Not that messed up leg still.
Now I know y'all gonna see a lot of me doubting myself.
We did.
And I don't know where it really came from. Cause I walked in and I felt, you know.
I love how there's just titties in there.
I'm that bitch
from
the game. At some point down the line, I got my own way and couldn't move my big ass out of the way.
I mean, at least she knows that that's what it was. Like, well, it's unfortunate that she couldn't see that earlier. Yeah.
I didn't agree wholeheartedly that I was standing in my own way and not letting my light shine.
But bitch, you made it to RuPaul's Drag Race. I mean... That's a big deal.
Did no one
give her letters?
Oh, maybe. But
I
think she probably didn't have time
like
for it.
The way I came in. Relax your throat, bitches.
Gotcha.
You just begun, and you're still gagging.
Oh.
This is only the tip.
Love that.
Whenever you are in doubt, rub them thighs together and remember who the you are.
I love that.
Now,
six queens remain.
Six queens remain!
Guys, what are your thoughts? What was your favorite runway look? Do you think the right queen went home? Let us know in a comment down below, bitch. Make sure you go check out our celebrity. I was about to say Big Brother. Celebrity RuPaul, because it's going to be up. Hopefully it's up now, so make sure to check that out. If you're not already subscribed, please go ahead and subscribe. If you want to follow us on Instagram, our Instagrams will be down below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and just remember, stay dandy.
Bye!
Pump Spice Diet Coach, try to be a basic bitch like me. Pump Spice Diet Coach, try to be a basic bitch like me. Pump Spice Diet Coach, try to be a basic bitch like me. Pump Spice Diet Coach, try to be a basic bitch like me.